Hello everyone, my name is Sumit. Welcome to my channel Sumit Tube. In this tutorial series, we will learn how to design beautiful apps using MATLAB App Designer. We will start with the basics, like how to drag and drop components, edit their properties, and write callback functions. We will be designing all of our apps from scratch and explaining the process step by step, making it very easy to understand the design flow. First, we will learn about different components by creating some simple apps. Then we will design professional apps that include different components, private and public properties and functions. We will also cover some complex examples such as designing multi-window apps. After designing apps, we will learn how to make standalone desktop applications and share them with other users. They can install and run the app like any other app without needing to have MATLAB installed on their computers. I'll create a YouTube playlist including all the MATLAB App Designer videos. I recommend watching the videos in order so you don't miss anything. The MATLAB version I am using is 2023B, which is the latest version at the time of making this video. If you are using a different version, you may notice some differences, but the core functionality remains the same. So it does not matter which MATLAB version you are using. Okay, so let's get started. Today we are going to learn how to add plot in MATLAB App Designer. We are going to make this simple app where we are going to plot a sinusoidal signal as a function of time, where the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal is going to be controlled by this knob. So if we increase this knob value, the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal should rise. On the other hand, if we decrease this knob value, the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal should decrease. So it would work something like this. Let's increase the knob value, and as you can see, the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal is increasing. In the same way, if we decrease this knob value, this sinusoidal signal would decrease. So let's see how we can build this simple app. In a previous tutorial video, we have learned how to use knob in MATLAB App Designer. As we are going to use this knob component in today's app design, I would recommend to watch that video first. You can find the link in the description below. Okay, so I already have opened a new app file. Now let's take a look at this component browser. So first thing you can see is our app. This is our whole app. Now it holds a component which is called UI figure. This is our UI figure. It stands for user interface figure. This is the main component. This is where we are going to place different components and make our figure. Okay, so first thing we need is our access component. You can see under component library and common tab, access is the first component. So let's take it and drop it in our UI figure window. Okay, let's make it bigger so you can see easily. Okay, also change the font size to 80. Okay, as you can see, it comes with this default title, Y and X. You can change it from this label window. Let's change the title to, let's say, My Plot. Okay, now in X axis would be the time, as we are going to draw the sinusoidal waveform as a function of time. In Y label, we can say our sinusoidal signal. So we can write sinusoidal. Now, if you want multi-line string, then you can press enter in your keyboard. You can see it goes to the second line, and then you can type signal. Now, to see the change, you have to click outside. You can click anywhere. If you click outside, you can see it is showing double line. Anyway, we can make it single line. We don't need this double line. Okay, sinusoidal signal. Okay, so this is our different types of label properties. Now there are several properties. As you can see, it is here font properties. You can see also ticks properties. Here you can see ruler, different types of grids like X grid, Y grid. Anyway, there are so many properties, you can go there one by one and see what happens. Now, one thing we can change, for example, click on this box styling. As you can see, right now box is only here left and right. We can form a rectangular box. For this, just check this box, and as you can see, the box all around the here. Okay, so this is our access. Now we need one more component, which is our knob component. For this, go to all to the bottom to this instrumentation tab, and you can see here knob. This is the continuous knob which we are going to use. Anyway, let's delete this associated label. Okay, let's resize it a little bit and make it bigger so you can see easily. Okay, now let's change the font size to say 24. We don't need the limit from 0 to 100, so let's make the limit from 0 to say 10. Okay, so we have placed all our necessary components. All of our app is ready. Now let's understand some basics. Okay, now we all know the basics of plotting. Here we have X and Y data sets. We place them and then add them to get the plot. Now to achieve this effect in MATLAB, we have a simple command which is plot X, Y. Now when we use this command in MATLAB, a certain chain of process happens. MATLAB first creates a figure, then creates an axis inside this figure, and then puts the plot inside this axis. And it automatically creates the hierarchy between them. Here figure window holds the axis window and axis window holds the plot. Now we don't see this process because MATLAB automatically does it for us in the background. Now MATLAB App Designer is slightly different. We already have the figure window and the axis window because we already have created them. Now we don't want our plot to be anywhere. We want our plot in this specific axis which we have created. For this, we have to add this as the first argument for plot related command. So to get the plot, we have to write plot app.eyaccess. Here eyaccess is the name of our access. So this would act as the target for our resulting plot. Then we have to write our normal X, Y, and we can see the plot inside this app designer access. Okay, now let's see these two side by side to understand the difference. On the left hand side, we would see regular MATLAB plot, and on the right hand side, we would see app designer plot. Now for regular MATLAB plot, we would write plot X, Y, and MATLAB would automatically create the figure, axis, and the plot. Now for App Designer, we already have the figure and the axis. We have to mention this axis as the first argument for our plot command. So we would write plot app.uiaccess, X, Y, and we would see our plot. Now to add title to regular MATLAB plot, we would title and our my title would appear here. Now to achieve the same effect for App Designer, we have to mention this app.uiaccess as the first argument for our title command, and we would see our my title in the App Designer. Now to have grid on regular MATLAB, we simply write grid on and we can see the grid in the regular MATLAB plot. Now to have the grid on the App Designer, we have to again mention this app.uiaccess as the first argument, and we can see our grid in the App Designer. Hopefully you have already get the picture. For App Designer, you have always have to mention this app.uiaccess as the first argument of any plot related commands. Now sinusoidal signal can be represented as amplitude into sine twice pi into frequency into time. We want the amplitude part of the sinusoidal signal to be controlled by this knob. So if we plot sinusoidal function as a function of time, this is the peak value or the maximum value. So this is the amplitude line. We want this amplitude line to be controlled by this knob. Now there are two components in our App Designer. One is knob and another one is this UI axis. We have to write the callback function for this knob as we are going to control the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal using this knob. Now if you remember, knob has two different types of callback function. One is called value changed callback function and another one is called value changing callback function. Both of these callback function has two arguments. One is app argument and second one is event argument. For value changed callback, we use this app argument and we get the value using this app.knob.value notation. For value changing callback, we use the event argument to get the value, which is event.value. If we want to see the continuous change, we have to use this value changing callback function. Okay, So as we are going to see the continuous change, if we change the knob value, we should see sinusoidal signal gradually change. Right now, the knob value is set to 5 and the amplitude of the sinusoidal signal is 5. If we change the value, that means if we increase the value from 5 to 10, we should see the sinusoidal signal is gradually increasing. At the same time, if we decrease the value from 10 to 5, we should see the value of the sinusoidal signal is gradually decreasing. Okay, so we have to write our callback function. We are going to write callback function for this knob. So first select this and go to this callbacks tab of the knob. As we mentioned earlier, we are going to write this value changing callback function for this knob. So select this drop down menu and add a value changing callback function. Okay, as you can see here, right now we are inside this value changing callback function of this knob. And as you can see, the name of the callback function is knob value changing. So we have to write our callback function here. Now we can express the sinusoidal signal mathematically as sig is equal to A into sine twice by Ft. Here sig stands for sinusoidal signal. A means amplitude, F means frequency, and T stands for time. Now this amplitude part would be controlled by the knob. What about the other parameters? That means frequency and time. Now we can start our signal at any time. For simplicity, let's start the time to 0 and let's end the time to 1. So time would be 0 to 1. And as you can see, we have just one cycle in this once again. So the frequency is also 1. Okay, now it's time to write the callback function. Let's first set the parameters. Let's create a time vector t which starts from 0 and ends at 1, and we are using time interval of 0.01 second. And then create a variable for our amplitude a, and this is going to get the value from knob. As we are going to use the value changing callback, we are going to use this event dot value notation. And for simplicity, we are considering frequency value is equal to 1. Now let's create the sinusoidal signal, which is sig is equal to A into sine twice pi Ft. Now to get the plot, we have to use this app.eyxs as the first argument, and we are going to see this time versus signal. Now we need to freeze the y-axis. Why do we need to do that? You are going to understand it in a moment. Okay, so we have completed writing our callback function. Now let's run this program and see the result. Let's maximize this window. Okay, right now the value is set to 0. As you can see, there is nothing inside this plot. That's because we have written callback function for this knob. As I have not interacted with this knob, this callback function has not executed. And that's why you cannot see anything. To see something, we have to interact with this knob. So let's change the value from 0 to 10. So let's increase the value and let's see what happens. We expect the amplitude should gradually increase as we increase the knob value. Okay, so let's increase the value. But what is happening? As you can see, value is increasing, but sometimes value is decreasing. Why this one is happening? Okay, now let's decrease the knob value. As you can see, same thing is happening. Value is decreasing, but sometimes value is increasing. Why this one is happening? To understand this, take a close look at this maximum value. Right now, the maximum value is set to 1. So if we change this value to 1, we can see a sinusoidal signal of amplitude 1. Now, what happens if we change this knob value from 1 to 2? You may think this value has not increased, but actually value has increased. As you can see, value is set to 2. So what is actually happening? Every time we are changing this knob value, MATLAB automatically sets this y-axis limit. It is setting this maximum value and minimum value. That's why it looks like this value is not increasing, but actually value is increasing. For example, if I change this value to 5, right now maximum value is set to 5. So if we increase the value, every time it is trying to set this axis limit. That's why you cannot see this value is continuously increasing. So to look at the effect, what we can do, we can freeze this y-axis limit. The maximum value would be 10 because the maximum knob value is 10 and minimum value would be minus 10. So what we can do, we can set the Y limit from 10 to minus 10. Okay, so let's do it. So that's why we need to freeze this Y axis. To freeze Y axis, we need this Y lim function. Okay, but remember, always we have to use this UI axis as the first argument. And then our limit is minimum value is minus 10 and maximum Y value would be plus 10. Okay, now let's run this program and let's see. Okay, now let's increase the knob value. As you can see, the value is gradually increasing. This is what we are expecting. Right now it is working as we see in our normal oscilloscope. As you can see, maximum value is 10, minimum value is minus 10. Now if we decrease the knob, as you can see, value is decreasing gradually. So for this, you have to set this Y limit property of the axis. That's all from today's video. Hope you have learned something new today. Let me know your thoughts about this tutorial series. Add your comments below this video. As usual, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I am going to catch you in the next video.